So welcome to lesson number two. What are we going to be doing in this lesson? We are going to be looking at a comparison between past and present views on children. כלומר, אנחנו ניכנס קצת יותר לעומק על כיצד ראו ילדים בעבר בהקשר של צרכנות לבין כיצד רואים ילדים היום. We're also going to be trying to understand expressions in the text. כן, מה קורה שיש איזשהו ביטוי בתוך הטקסט? איך אפשר להתמודד עם זה ולהבין את זה בתוך ההקשר? We're going to be looking at definitions. כן, כל הזמן אנחנו מסתכלים על הגדרות. נורא חשוב לדעת ולזהות הגדרות בתוך הטקסט. And we're also going to be focusing again on the relationship between cause and result, בין סיבה לתוצאה. So, let's look at paragraph one again, and think about the following question. How did retailers perceive children in the past? Okay, so retailers, כן, הקמעונאים, המוכרים. So how did they see children in the past? So read paragraph one and focus on what was the main focus in the past? Now, when you're looking for the answer, look for words that refer you to the past. כן, חפשו מילים שמתייחסות לעבר. So, for example, the beginning of paragraph one. There was a time, in fact, only 30 or 40 years ago when children were not spoken of as spenders or customers, but as savers and future customers. Okay, so there was a time, and what happened at that time? Now also, if you continue reading, it says here, children had money, but it was for saving, not spending. So here again, the writer is repeating the main idea from the beginning of the paragraph. Now, you should have also noticed words like savers, saving, to save up for, לחסוך ל, and again, save up for. Now, whenever you have words in a text that are repeated, הם חוזרים על עצמם כל הזמן, הכותבים מנסים להדגיש את החשיבות של המושגים האלה. So, if you want to give an answer, the answer should look something like this, okay? Children were seen as, or perceived as, savers and future consumers. כלומר, ראו בילדים כחוסכים, לחוסכים, ובעצם צרכנים עתידיים. Okay. So, let's continue to paragraph number two, and let's look at the following expression, הביטוי. What is the expression, a penny saved is a penny earned, mean in this text? Okay. Now remember, when you're looking for the meaning of an expression, okay, find the expression in the text, and then read from the beginning, so you'll have some sort of context, כדי שיהיה לכם הקשר, ואז תצטרכו כנראה להסיק, you have to infer your answer. לא תמיד כתוב בצורה מפורשת, אלא צריך לקרוא בין השורות, מתוך ההקשר להבין מה המשמעות של הביטוי הזה, בהקשר של ילדים צרכנים, ילדים חסכנים, לעומת ילדים שמוציאים כספים. Okay, so I'm sure that you read paragraph two, and you understood that the main issue of the first paragraphs is the issue of children saving money. Okay, so the possible answers for the meaning of this expression, a penny saved is a penny earned, could be, perhaps, parents encouraged children to save, כן, ילדים, הורים, עודדו ילדים לחסוך. Or another possible answer could be, the expression repeats the writer's main point, that in the past, saving money was the principal goal, כן? יכול להיות שהביטוי באמת מחזק וחוזר על הרעיון המרכזי, שהמטרה המרכזית בעבר הייתה של חיסכון ולא של הוצאת כספים. Another possible answer could be that it's important to save money for the future and not spend it. כן, חשוב לחסוך את הכסף ולא להוציא את הכסף. So, let's also go to paragraph four. And in paragraph four, the writer mentions the phenomenon, the baby boom. Okay, the baby boom or baby boom. What I want you to do is read paragraph four and look for the definition given in the text. Now, of course, if you know what the meaning of baby boom is, that's perfect. But still, we want to see how the writer defines this phrase. So scan the text, look for the words, and then look for the writer's definition. So at the beginning of paragraph four, we know that the writer is talking about the change from children as savers to children as spenders. And he says that the change occurs with a phenomenon called the baby boom. כן, עם איזושהי תופעה שנקראת ה-baby boom. עכשיו, יכול להיות שאתם מכירים את המושג הזה מעברית, מכל מיני תוכניות טלוויזיה למיניהם. זה מצוין, אבל אנחנו באמת רוצים לקרוא ולראות כיצד הכותב מגדיר את המושג הזה. So if you keep on reading after the expression, we get the meaning of the writer. It says here, when World War II ended, families started having babies as if they were making up for all the lost war years. By 1950, the under 5 population was 16,163,000, an unheard of 60% increase in 10 years. So what they're saying is that after the war, there was a huge increase of babies, of births. Okay. Now let's look at this graph, okay? This graph actually shows us visually the baby boom and what happened, okay? So here we have on this graph the United States birth rates from 1940 to 1980. And as you can see in the red, okay, there's a huge increase of births during this time. And this generation, הדור הזה של ילדים שנולדו אחרי מלחמת העולם השנייה, נקרא הדור של ה-baby boomers. So let's read paragraph number four, and let's focus on the following question. What two factors led to the change from savers to spenders? Now let's focus for a second on the word factors. Factors means גורמים, and sometimes people get confused with the word fact, עובדה, לעומת factors, גורמים. זה שני דברים שונים לחלוטין. And so what are we focusing on in this question? We're looking for the two reasons, מהם שני הגורמים או שתי הסיבות, שגרמו למעבר מילדים שחוסכים לילדים שמוציאים את הכספים. Okay, so because we know that we're looking for two factors, שני גורמים, מאוד כדאי לשים לב למילים שנותנים לנו רשימה בתוך טקסט, מילים כמו moreover, יתרה מכך, and words like also, גם כן. Okay, so if you're not even sure what the answer is, but you see words like this, you know that you have here more than one item. You should tell me parit echad. So moreover, okay, means yetera mikach. So this tells me that if I'm looking for two factors, for sure there was a factor before. Haya gorem lifnei. This brings us to the word as, kasher. Okay, the word as tells me that I'm getting a cause. Is she sibah? למה? כאשר מה? משהו קרה, okay? So let's continue reading from here for the answer. As these baby boomers reached ages 5 to 12, their small amount of spending became very noticeable because of their substantially increased numbers. So again, the word because is another word of factor, okay? Then let's continue reading. Moreover, these were prosperous years, and the amount that each child could spend also increased. So let's summarize the answers here in the text. Okay, and so the first factor was the increased number of baby boomers who were spending money. So all of a sudden there were a lot of children who grew up, and they had money to spend. And the second factor was the increased amount of money spent by these children. כלומר, not only were there more kids with money, but these kids were spending the money. כן, הם הוציאו את הכספים גם כן במקביל. So this brings us to the relationship between cause and result, הקשר בין סיבה לתוצאה. And sometimes this relationship is hard to understand in a text. קשה באמת להבין את הקשר בין סיבה לתוצאה בתוך טקסט, עוד במיוחד בטקסט, בשפה זרה. Okay, so let's try and help you guys find when a text is talking about a factor, a cause, and when it's talking about a result. So what is a cause, actually? A cause is why something happens, כן? סיבה זה למה משהו קורה. מה הסיבה לכך? Okay? In Hebrew, ask yourselves the question, למה זה קרה או מאיזו סיבה? ונתן לכם התשובה על זה, זאת הסיבה. Okay? Now, when you're looking for a result is an effect. It's what happens in a as a result. מה קורה כתוצאה? And in Hebrew, ask yourselves, מה קרה בעצם? כן? למה משהו קרה זאת הסיבה? ומה קרה בסופו של דבר זאת התוצאה? So if you think about the relationship in these terms, it's much easier to understand. Okay? Also, you can look for words like as, כאשר, כמו בתוך הטקסט, because, בגלל, since, גם כן בגלל, due to, זה הודות ל, בגלל. And then you have words of result, so, לכן, okay, as a result, כתוצאה מכך. Words like increased, decreased, כן, פעלים. פעלים זה בעצם תוצאה, כי משהו קרה או התרחש. זה גם כן רמז לתוצאה. And of course, the word thus, גם כן לכן, נותן לנו סיכום ותוצאה. So now we're going to go on to paragraph 5 and focus on this question. In what way has retailers' perception of children changed over time? Now we're looking at retailers' perception. כן? התפיסה של הקמעונאים לגבי ילדים. So how did their understanding of children change over time? Read paragraph 5 and answer the question. Now, when you're looking for a change, you have to say that something is different. משהו השתנה, איזשהו שינוי. Okay? So remember that even if you're answering this question from paragraph 5, you shouldn't forget what you've read before. אל תשכחו מה שקראתם עד לנקודה הזאת, כי כל פסקה בעצם מתווספת למה שקראתם מקודם. Okay? So in the text, notice the word but today. Children are viewed as a viable market, כן? כשוק בר קיימא, כשוק שקיים שם כדי לשווק לו. Okay? So the answer should be that today, retailers view children as a viable market and no longer as savers. הם כבר לא רואים בהם כחסכנים או כחוסכים, אלא בעצם כקונים פוטנציאליים. So let's summarize what we've read in the introductory section in paragraphs 1 till 5. So how were children viewed in the past? They were viewed as savers and future consumers, כן, כחוסכים וכצרכנים עתידיים. Then after the baby boom, remember what happened after World War II when all of the men came home, okay, we had an increase in births. And this generation actually changed the perception of children as consumers. And today they're seen as spenders, כמוציאים כספים, and today's consumers, והצרכנים של היום.